Hare Krishna. Question from Vaishak R. Prabhu. Does the anthropic principle disprove the existence of design or the design argument? Is the design in the universe that we see around us just by chance among one of the innumerable universes that are possible? Answer, not necessarily that either disprove the design argument. First, let's understand what the anthropic principle is. Then we will look at what its implications are and how atheists misconstrue that implication. So firstly, anthropic principle is a description, it's not an explanation. Description means that it's a something which is already observed and we give a name to it, and that is called a description. Explanation essentially means that there is a cause given for it. So only when we give a cause, then we can say that it's an explanation. But otherwise, it's just a it's a description. So, for example, if we find a flower of a particular color, which we don't know, and then we give us a name for that color. Now, giving a name for that color doesn't explain why that flower acquired that color. So naming or describing is not the same as explaining. It's a simple point to understand, but this is critical to understand that the anthropic principle is a descriptive name. It's not an explanation because it does not ascribe any causes. So what is the anthropic principle? This is, in simple terms, that the universe is made or is set up in such a way, universe is in such a way that it is perfect for our life, for our existence, for our survival, because if it hadn't been, then we wouldn't be here to ask the question, how it is perfect. So for example, the idea that, say, the earth is tilted at exactly 23.5 degrees, or that the distance between the earth and moon is of a particular distance, or the distance between earth and Jupiter is particular, or the ratio of the strong force and the weak force in the atom is of a particular value. So all these universal constants and relationships between them, why are they the way they are? That's because, I said, if they weren't that way, we wouldn't be alive. And if we wouldn't be alive, then we would not be asking the question, why they are like this. Yes, that is fine, but that doesn't answer the question at all. If I am dying of thirst and hunger, and I fall unconscious in a desert, and I am thinking that this unconsciousness is going to be the cause of death, my death, and suddenly somehow I come out of my consciousness, and then I see that there are several jugs of water, and there is a delicious feast kept in front of me, and then I eat it and I live, and then I wonder who brought this. And if I try to tell myself, who brought this, actually, how did this come over here in this forest, in this desert? If it had not come here, then you would not be alive to ask this question. That's fine. That's true, but that doesn't explain at all how it came here. So there's an article on this website called Made Just For You, in which I've analyzed how the anomalous behavior of water is not anomalous at all for the aquatic life form. It is exactly essential for their survival, perfect for their survival, in fact. So how has that come about? Now, without that, the aquatic life form would not survive, that's true, but that doesn't explain where it came from. So the anthropic principle is not a is simply an explanatory is simply a descriptive tool. It's not an explanatory principle which goes to some causes. So why is the earth tilted at 23.5 degrees? Well, if it weren't, we would not be alive to ask this question. That's fine, but that still doesn't answer the question why it is like that. So then this anthropic principle has been, because the anthropic principle points very strongly towards design, so the next question comes up, how do we get out of the design argument? That's what the atheists have been trying to do. So then they come up with the idea of the multiverse theory. So there are innumerable universes, and among the innumerable universes, in one of the universes, the factors have come out just right. So if that is the case, then there is no question of chance coming up. So if I say the probability of the Earth being tilted 23.5 degrees is just 1 in 10 billion, then we say there are 10 billion universes, and then out of them, one of them has the Earth tilted like that. So whatever be the probable low, whatever, however low the probability will be, one can just expand the number of universes to that much and say that everything has, it's just by chance in one of the many universes. Now the problems with this are twofold. First of all, many eminent scientists have pointed out that this concept of multiple universes, parallel universes, is science fiction, not science. In the answer to another question about M theory, I have quoted also eminent scientists talking about talking very critically about this about parallel universe idea, innumerable universe. It is just is imagination, which is not only unproven but is also unprovable, because these are universes in parallel, they cannot be proven at all. So firstly, they fit in the realm of science fiction, and secondly, more importantly, they don't solve the problem of probability. Because yes, I say the probability of the Earth being tilted is 1 in 10 billion, and then there are 10 billion universes. So now in one of those universes, the Earth will be tilted at 23.5 degrees. But why should that be the universe that I am in? Or why, more specifically, why should it be this universe? So if I throw 6 dice and I could say that the probability is that one of them will fall 6. Yes, but if I have found a dice which has fallen 6, then that this dice has to fall 6. So even if there are 6 dices being thrown up, the question, question is, one of them falling 6, the probability is increased to, you could say, almost 1. But the probability of this particular dice in front of me coming 6 is not increased. It remains the same, 1 out of 6. So the probability problem is not solved. It still remains. By positing innumerable universes, we may solve the problem of how it occurred, but still we can't solve the problem of how it occurred in this particular universe in which we are living in. Therefore, this positing the multiple universes theory also does not do away with the design implications that very clearly come up from the anthropic principle. Thank you. Hare Krishna.